The following presentation is brought to you by Virginia Credit Union.
Welcome to the webinar, Planning Your Family Finances, brought to you by Virginia Credit Union. My name is Cherry Dale, and I'm the VP of Financial Education. I've been with the credit union for over 13 years and have a lot of experience when it comes to family. This is a lovely collage of and pictures of my family. My children's ages range from 3 all the way to 23. My father is pictured in this collage, and so is my husband. So when it comes to family, I like to focus in on three things as we're discussing finances. Communicate, have a plan, and be accountable. We're going to take each three of these topics and integrate them with our children, with our spouse or significant other, and then also talking about communicating and having a plan with our aging parent. So let's get started. Are you in a relationship with a significant other? Perhaps you've been in a relationship a long time, or maybe you're just getting started. When it comes to finances, though, it's never too early to start talking about them. And I tell you what, money is one of the number one things that couples tend to argue about. So if you can communicate, create a plan, and hold each other accountable in this process, you are setting yourself up for success financially as a couple. So when we talk about communicating, it's important to hit on what you truly value, individually, and then coming together as a couple. So thinking through, okay, how has my past experiences, the way I was raised, the values that were ingrained within myself, and what I bring to the table mesh with my partner's values as well, and discussing those. So for example, your partner might really value this idea of security. So, you know, having it brings some comfort to perhaps have some savings in the bank. And maybe you're more of a spender because you really value freedom. Well, if you guys can communicate about those two things, because those are the opposite ends of the financial spectrum, it will better help you understand each other, and then you can develop a plan around what's truly important to you as a couple. Talk about your dreams, talk about your expectations, and then take all of those things and create a financial plan together. You're going to organize this, you're going to create some financial goals around that. We call them SMART goals: specific, measurable, attainable, reasonable, and time-bound. Here's an example. Let's say you guys want to buy a house together. You want to buy a house around $200,000. So you want a very specific amount. You're going to take that then and say, okay, what are some things that we have to do in order to get there? Well, part of that might be having a down payment. So let's say you want to put aside $16,000, your time frame's around 2 years. So you know, as a couple, you're working toward this down payment goal. If you break that up with 2 years, 24 months, you're looking at around $666 a month. If you get paid twice a month, that's $333 a paycheck, which breaks down, if you divide that by two, if you're both working, you're looking at around $166 per paycheck that you each need to set aside to work toward this down payment goal. You can take this idea and implement it with perhaps travel goal. Maybe you want to go overseas. My husband's from England. So it's very important for us as a family to be able to travel there every year. So we know that. So if we were to get a tax refund or a bonus or anything extra, we automatically put that into a pot so that we can travel. But being on the same page, creating those goals, and then budgeting for them. We're going to provide you some basic budget and goal sheets that you can download and have access to and work through with your partner together. You want to plan monthly meetings and maybe a date night. You know, go to dinner, talk about your dreams and your values, and then see where you are in your budget as well. That's rewarding some positive change. Right? And even taking a trip in of itself is kind of the reward. But you want to, you know, praise each other, figure out what makes each other happy or tick, as you might say, and then reward that process. Let's This is the couples worksheet that you can go right to our website and download. You can download the monthly budget worksheet, and we also have a goals sheet as well. Now, let's talk about kids. I have a 3-year-old, an 18-year-old, and a 23-year-old. So I had kids in my 20s, and then I had a brand new miracle baby in my 40s. Surprise! And I love Max. Max is my 3-year-old. But I've really had this second time around, it's given me truly an opportunity to take what I learned with my older boys and make sure that I do it right with my younger child. You know, if you can start communicating about your money values to your children at a young age, it's going to set them up for financial success in the long run. And I really believe the number one thing that we can teach our child, regardless of the age, is this concept of savings. Savings is not an intrinsically natural thing that we as humans want to do necessarily. So it's a more of a learned behavior of a habit. So if you're, you know, providing an allowance for your child or paying them for chores, having that conversation around, okay, let's save 10% of what we get into a savings jar. You can create a poster or just grab just a regular jar and put money toward something that they're working toward. Communicate about what your expectations are. We communicate about expected behavior in all sorts of areas, but when it comes to money, sometimes we as parents fall short. So for example, if you are going on a family vacation, you want to communicate how much money you might be willing to give your child and then the expectations around that. What about if you have a teenager, you're going to communicate about car buying, who is buying what, or if they are buying it, and then create a plan around that. What about college as well? You can talk to your middle school or your high school about how much college is going to cost and who is paying for what, and develop a plan around that. You want to bring in your personal stories. I think sometimes we feel like maybe we shouldn't share everything with our kids, and that's fine, but you want to be open and honest and tell them about your past experiences when it's appropriate. You want to reward positive behavior, you know, and then be consistent as well. So hold yourself accountable. I learned this with my older children. You know, if you're going to give cash for your child's allowance, make sure you have cash on hand, because we live in a cashless society. So making that effort to, oh, I've got to, you know, get $20 from the ATM or $20 cash back to actually have cash to give my kid for their allowance. So communicate, make that plan with your child and hold them accountable. We have a couple of different fun worksheets that you can do with your child. This is for maybe a K or a K through one child or even younger. You take a bag of M&Ms, you separate them by color, and you graph. And then you can talk about, okay, if this was actually money, you could spend this much on toys, this much on food, savings, clothes, give, shelter. So just discussing and bringing up the concept of what money in and of itself could go toward. Parents, for me, and my father is still alive, thankfully. 8 years ago, unfortunately, I did lose my mom. So going through that experience really brought to life the importance of having a financial plan when it comes to your very own parents. After my mom passed away, thankfully, my brother and I were able to sit down with my dad and communicate about what was going on with their finances. We developed a financial plan, and we discussed things like where the documents were going to be kept, what insurance policies were there, where my father banked, passwords, things like that. You need to have that discussion, because if you were just to suddenly lose your parents and they weren't there to walk you through that, it's going to take months to, you know, even get started in that process. And I know it can be quite difficult to even bring this up with your parents, but, you know, maybe ease into it. So when you're talking about communicating, you know, bring it up gradually. And then as you're doing that, you can hold each other accountable each month, perhaps set up quarterly meetings. And what we're providing for you today is several different notebook pages about talking to your parents and creating this idea of a financial notebook so you know exactly where things are, what things need to be done, and then you guys can chart out a process together. You know, you could just bring this up in a casual conversation. Hey, I attended this webinar through my credit union. They were talking about creating a financial notebook. Let's sit down and look through these things and see where we are in this process. And then have a plan for the year. Baby steps, but if you can really sit down and create like a monthly plan to meet with your parents, and then, you know, the first month you're working through these documents, and then the next month you bring in, if you need to, an outside resource to help you along the way, make sure you're communicating with other family members as well. My brother and I sat down and really had a heart-to-heart conversation about who was comfortable managing what when it came to my father's finances. So again, the three things you want to focus in on with your family is to communicate, have a plan, be accountable. It's so important. And I tell you what, I taught at the Longwood University for 4 years, college students, this information. And what I found when I was working with the students is, you know what? This, they realized in college how important it was to have the conversation with their parents and to find out where everyone was to make sure that they were on the same page. So I think you will find that people are open to this and want to have a plan. If you're feeling overwhelmed, just take one step at a time. Concentrate first on your significant other relationship, then maybe your children, and then ease into that parent conversation. But you really want to take care of yourself first and have your own financial plan. Thank you so much for joining us today. Virginia Credit Union has many resources to help you on your financial journey. We partner with this organization called Balance for some financial coaching if you would like extra assistance. I am also available to meet with you. If you go to our website at vacu.org/educators, there's a button you can click on and you can sign up to meet with a financial educator at Virginia Credit Union. This is also my email, so feel free to reach out and email me any thoughts or questions. Thank you so much, and I look forward to seeing you again. Take care.